CO2. One of the topics that comes up very often in aquarium hobby. Some people like it, some seem to think it's not that necessary, but everyone agrees that it really helps with faster plant growth, better plant health and looks, pH regulation, and few more things. And few months back, I made a video where I was comparing three most popular CO2 systems that I was using myself. And a lot of you were really interested in this one, my CO2 system based on baking soda and citric acid. So today I will show you more about it and I will try to address all the questions that you had. Let's get started. This is the system that I will be using. I got it online from a company called Invital, or maybe Invital, I don't know. And before I move on, very important thing you need to know. This is not a sponsored video. I bought this system for myself and Invital doesn't even know that I'm mentioning them in this video. My set was including the stainless steel reactor, regulator, bubble counter, some tubing, and all ingredients for the reaction. And it also comes with very important part attached to the regulator, solenoid. I'm mentioning this because not all sets have exactly the same specification, so check what you get for your money. Especially check if the solenoid is included. I got my set for around 70 euros, but like I said, don't look at the price only. Now let's talk about how it works. The entire system is using similar concept as very cheap DIY system based on yeast. Only this time, the reaction that will produce CO2 will happen in that cylinder. This is more or less how it works. You need to have three main ingredients. Water, and that's not really a secret. Very secret ingredient number one, which everybody knows is citric acid. And even more secret ingredient number two, and that is baking soda. But what's the secret then? Well, those are very cheap products that everyone can buy at almost every store. But some companies try to make it a secret so they can sell it at higher prices. So they call it ingredient number one and two, bag number one and two, and so on. But seriously guys, everybody knows. But the main point is this, if you mix those three things, this happens. You can see that there is a chemical reaction happening inside this glass, and the byproduct of it is CO2. So, if you are able to contain it and dose it in small amounts, it's perfect for our needs. And this is exactly what this system is doing for us. I know that there are a lot of people still hesitant to use CO2, mostly because they are afraid it might be complicated, is it safe, and so on. So now I will show you how to do it step by step and how easy it can be. So enough talking, let's just do it. At the very beginning, we will start from preparing the solution for the cylinder. So let's open this refill bag and get those two magical ingredients out. Additionally, you will need some water. In my case, it's exactly 300 milliliters. Next step is to combine those three things together. But before you do that, two things. First, make sure that you have this regulator ready and closed by. This is because the reaction happens quite fast, and once you put those three things together, you have to close the system as soon as possible. And make sure that it's actually closed. Otherwise, all CO2 will be escaping from the start, and you will not be able to build any pressure in the cylinder. And here I have to give a big plus to those Invital refill bags. You see, this bag of baking soda is closed in special foil that reacts with water and dissolves inside the cylinder. So you don't open it at all. You just need to throw it inside exactly like that. This gives you more time to close the cylinder and avoid any mess. Very clever and good idea. So first, I'm pouring 300 milliliters of water into the cylinder. Next, I'm putting the first ingredient. And finally, this dissolvable bag I mentioned. And before it dissolves and releases the baking soda, I have some time. So next, I quickly screw the regulator on top of it. Make sure it's tight. And that's it. From now on, we will see the pressure rising inside right here on this gauge. It should be ready after about 6 hours in case of my setup. And we can use this time to finish setting up the rest of the system. I mean like few minutes, not all 6 hours. This part right there is the solenoid. It's not connected yet, and that means that it's closed and no CO2 will go through it. Once you plug it in, it will open and let the CO2 through. This is how you can easily switch it on and off. And to do that, I strongly recommend to use one of these. This is a smart plug. They are very easy to use and you can program them with your phone to always switch on and off at the specific time of the day. Super easy and very convenient way to automate the entire process. This is the bubble counter that will help us measure how much CO2 is getting into the tank. To prepare it, I'm filling it up with water. And now it's ready. We place it right here, after the solenoid. And once the system is ready to go and solenoid opens, you will see the bubbles going through it. More bubbles means more CO2 in your tank. And lastly, we connect the bubble counter to the diffuser using high pressure tubing. Diffuser was not included into this set, so you will have to buy it separately. But anyway, this is it. See? All it takes is few minutes of your work and we are ready to go. I mean after the pressure builds up in the cylinder. Here I also have to warn you, this cylinder will get really cold at first, but don't worry because it's normal. And after a few hours, here we are. Like you can see here, the pressure is there. I can see the bubbles going through the counter. And we see CO2 coming from the diffuser. Everything is working just great. I can adjust the flow with this valve. See how much faster it's going through it now. I can switch it off at night. But most important, it's just ready to be used in one of my tanks. And last thing to remember, not all systems based on this formula are exactly the same, but all of them are working on the same principle. Just follow the instructions on your set and you will be good. Now I would like to address a few questions I got from you. First, is it safe? Yes, in my opinion, this solution is very safe. It will not blow up or anything. I actually have 2 of those and they are both doing great. I consider them to be much safer than DIY systems made from plastic bottles. Second, how long it will last? Well, this one strongly depends on the size of your tank and the amount of CO2 that you are using. But it lasts surprisingly long. For me, in 35 liter tank, it was running for 10 weeks, 7 hours a day, 2 bubbles per second. 3. Is it hard to clean? No, I never had any problems with it. I just make sure that all of the CO2 is used. I open it slowly and remove remaining solution from the cylinder, and then clean it with water. It takes no longer than 10 minutes. 4. Can I kill my fish with CO2? Yes, you definitely can. So make sure that you are dosing proper amounts and switch it off at night if you can. If you are not sure how to check CO2 levels, I'm linking a video about drop checkers that will help you understand how to measure CO2. If you are inexperienced with it, this is actually quite important. Number 5. How do I know when it's running low? You will know based on this gauge right here. When the pressure starts to drop, it will be a sign for you that there is very little CO2 left and you should get ready to refill it. In general, I have many different CO2 systems and I was using them for years. And that approach is my favorite right now. It's very reliable, not that expensive, you don't have to take it anywhere to refill it, and I have full control over it. I like the fact that I don't have to rely on any outside factors when I'm running low and I can plan ahead. Besides, I always have a lot of ingredients available and I can refill it in just few minutes. And CO2 really helps with growing healthy plants, control the algae issues, and helps me with lowering my pH if it's needed. If you had any doubts about those systems, I hope that this video helped to get rid of them, so just give it a try. And if you still have any questions, don't hesitate to put them in the comment section. Leave a like if you like the video, because it really helps me out. But for now, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one.